So my name is Hanna Bandarenk. I'm a senior researcher from National Research and Electronic Technology from Moscow. And I also work as the head of laboratory at Plasmonic in Belarus. And I would like to share with you our idea on fabrication and simulation of zinc oxide nanowires coated with silver beds for sensing applications, in particular for CERS spectroscopy, surface enhanced Raman scattering spectroscopy. The talk will be divided into several parts. Firstly, I will speak about our motivation, about CERS effect and CERS active substrates. Then the main part will be devoted our CERS active substrates based on zinc oxide nanowires, some information on fabrication technique, morphology, simulation of electrodynamic properties and CERS activity, and I will finalize my talk with some summary remarks. Let's start from the introduction. The moving force of our research is an urgent need in sensitive express analysis just during several minutes for very accurate detection, identification, and structural study of target molecules to solve problems of medicine, for example, early medical diagnostics, pharmaceutics, some sanitary epidemic control, also forensics and food quality control. And if you will if you will look on the right part of this slide, you will find out that the number of papers devoted to biosensing has increased greatly during the last decade. Unfortunately, existing methods do not solve all these problems at one time. So each method is not bad to solve just a single or just a few tasks, but none of them solve all the problems. And where do we see the way out? Of course, this is a combination of optical spectroscopy and nanostructures. And the first place here goes to the surface enhanced Raman scattering spectroscopy, or in brief form, CERS spectroscopy, among fluorescence spectroscopy and surface plasmon resonance spectroscopy. So today we will talk about CERS spectroscopy, and let me just briefly describe the roots of CERS spectroscopy. This is a younger brother of Raman spectroscopy, which allows to understand the structure of organic molecules, of molecules with covalent and polar bonds. And in general, the Raman scattering spectroscopy is called as a molecule fingerprinting because it gives us an information about all vibrations of bonds in molecule under light excitation, laser or any other optical excitation. So this is very good for biomedical analysis because this is not invasive, provides high resolution, like light interference from water. But unfortunately, this is characterized by some disadvantage, such as narrow cross-section of Raman scattering. Just one Raman photon is scattered from a billion of exciting photons. So Raman spectroscopy does not provide sensitivity when we study analytes at low concentrations. So this is a problem, but in 1974, some smart guy, Martin Fleischmann, discovered that the CERS effect is provided by specific phenomena which take place between nanoparticles. So these effects provide all the benefits of ordinary Raman scattering spectroscopy together with a great enhancement factor up to several orders of magnitude. And nowadays, this is possible to detect single molecules using CERS active substrates. So just a few words about mechanisms. The first is chemical mechanism. This is generally accepted that mechanisms contribute to CERS effect. So chemical and electromagnetic, and chemical is typical in the situation when the molecule is directly adsorbed on the metallic nanoparticles, and usually chemical mechanism contributes about 10^3 enhancement factor. Better contribution is provided by electromagnetic mechanism because of collective oscillations of free electrons in surface limited nanoparticles. So due to these collective oscillations, the electromagnetic field around the nanoparticles is increased greatly, and we observe the increase of Raman photons scattered from molecules absorbed on metallic nanoparticles. So the electromagnetic mechanism provides enhancement factor over 6 orders of magnitude. And of course, for CERS active substrates, for fabrications of CERS active substrates, we need plasmonic nanoparticles in different shapes with sizes ranging from 10 nanometers to 150 nanometers. The strongest plasmonic metals are silver, gold, and copper. Copper is oxidized, so this is not very favorable for fabrication of CERS active substrates. And we need to immobilize nanoparticles in the way when the gap between them is very small. The optimal gap is 3 nanometers, and electromagnetic field from few nanoparticles is overlapped. So the number of scattered photons, Raman photons, also is increased due to this. There are two types of CERS active substrates, liquid types. So these are colloidal particles, which are not very convenient in use, but provide rather high enhancement factor, and solid CERS active substrates, which present quasi-ordered arrays of nanoparticles on the solid substrate. They're very good for practice, for clinical use, for use in research laboratories, and so on. And the substrates, the CERS active substrates, should, of course, be very active, should provide good storage stability, reproducibility, and of course, because they are consumables, they should be cost effective. Right now, there are many companies which produce CERS active substrates, but of course, there are room for improvement of morphology of CERS active substrates. And let me share in brief how we propose to do it. For example, we study the material which can be reused, in particular zinc nanowires coated with silver beads. And this is known that zinc oxide nanostructures can demonstrate photocatalytic activity. So after light excitation, they can be used a second time. So we expect to use it several times. But this is just a preliminary study, and I will show how we fabricate our substrates and simulate their properties. First, we use as a substrate oxidized silicon wafer. Then the zinc oxide seed layer is sputtered on the surface of silicon wafer. Then, in order to limit the area of for zinc oxide nanowires growth, we deposit silver nanoparticles, and the distance between nanoparticles is equal to their diameter. The mean distance is 30 nanometers. This zinc oxide nanowires are grown by hydrothermal deposition, and you see that they are connected in the dots. And finally, we use thermal evaporation of silver birds, and the diameter of final silver birds is 15 nanometers. Here you can see the nanowires before deposition of silver birds and after deposition of silver birds. And the sample presents a kind of quasi-odorate arrays of connected zinc oxide nanowires coated and coated with silver birds and free of silver birds. We simulated 3D geometry in console 5.3 of our structures. The geometric parameters are presented here. So the base of each group of zinc oxide nanowires is an octagon with a face length of 45 nanometers. Other parameters you can find here. I have already mentioned them. The conditions used are presented also here. We used plane wave. The wave propagation was normally directed to XY plane. We used three wavelengths, blue, red, and near infrared. The vector of electric field was parallel to y-axis, and some other conditions can be also find here. And let me just be closer to the end of presentation. So simulation showed that the distribution of the field a bit different on the top of nanowires, but the maximal electric field strength typically is equal under different excitation wavelength. We found out that the zinc oxide nanowires, despite beds, were found not contribute very well. The spectra on such sample were much more intensive. Three times more intensive than the spectra of zinc oxide nanowires free of silver birds. And at least, finally, I would like to enclose my talk with all the mentioned points. So we were able to fabricate very nice nanostructures based on zinc oxide and silver nanoparticles and silver beds that possessed prominent tertiary and nanovalor detection limit, because we used 200 nanomolar solution. So we simulated electric field strength distribution for different wavelengths, excitation wavelengths. And we also found out that according to simulation, the silver beds do not contribute much, shouldn't contribute much to the cells activity. We expected that they will not contribute, but in contrast to our expectations, the spectra on silver-coated zinc oxide nanowires were three times more intensive. So this is just the preliminary results, and we now study an ability for self-cleaning of these nanowires, and they're successful, and hope during the next oral presentation, maybe I will report them. So the work was supported by Russian Science Foundation, and I would like to thank you very much for your patience. I'm open for questions, but you can send me by email these questions or to Zoom room. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Igor, do you have a question?
On my opinion, it's a lot of technical problem for producers. microstructure, you need to organize a distribution of particles, need to grow like fibers. It's not so easy. Yes, in this case, it's a more technical problem. Yes.
You're right, but we have methodology which works.
Many steps, yes, and on mm-hmm. all steps need to organize control. In this case, in my opinion, and I think more logical to use more oriented or more fixed, because this is not control. This is like flower.
Okay, we will take it into account.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Gonzalo, maybe you have any.
No, just a curiosity. You use silver. I mean, you need a metal. It has to be a metal. No? You use silver. And in the case of copper, the problem was the oxide. Copper oxidized. Can you
we use silver.
Silver, maybe
possible platinum.
Yeah, but platinum will be more expensive.
Yes.
No? Actually, silver is the strongest plasmonic
it's the best.
Metal.
Okay,
yes.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your question.
You're welcome.
Mm-hmm.